Welcome to Cooking with Chef Tuan, and today we are making some delicious seared scallops with potato puree, sauteed mushrooms, some baby gailan, and a nice white wine cream sauce. Now these beautiful scallops we got were provided by my good friends down at Blue Runner Seafood Truck down here in Miami. So go check them out. I'll put a link down in the description box below to their page. And as usual, all the ingredients and measurements will be listed down below. Now the first thing we're gonna start prepping is our potatoes. Just peel these guys, slice them up, and get them boiled, ready for mash. I'm gonna be using a food mill to make these potatoes. Now the mushrooms that I have today are these little brown shimenjis and this king oyster mushroom. And also, don't be afraid to use any mushroom that you like. We have some beautiful salty guanciale that we're gonna slice into nice little slices so we can render all the fat off of them, crisp them up, and crumble them for our garnish at the end. Now for this vegetable, I'm using baby gailan, or people call it Chinese broccoli. I love this because it's got this nice hollow tube. It's got a really great and interesting texture when you bite into it. Now because these are such young shoots, you don't need to blanch it for any more than 10-15 seconds. And as you can see, it's already turning a dark green color. So once this happens, take it out and shock it into ice water. Now if you can't get your hands on this baby gailan, you can definitely use broccolini or broccoli rabe. Now we're just gonna set this on some paper towels and let them dry and just put them to a side until later. We will heat them up in a pan right before we plate the whole dish. All right, now that the potatoes are done, I'm using a food mill like I said earlier, and all you gotta do is just season it. I put in about 5 tablespoons of butter and just mix this until it's all nice and smooth. Once your butter is completely incorporated into the potatoes, add a little splash of heavy whipping cream to fortify the rich flavor of the potatoes and to give this a little silky texture. As you can see, these are super silky smooth. And I wanna give a huge shout out to the folks at Heston for sending me this beautiful 11-inch skillet from their NanoBond series. I love this pan. And I will also put a link down in the description box to hestanculinary, so you can go and check out all the awesome equipment and pots and pans that they have. All right, so now we're just rendering out all the fat from the guanciale. It's not gonna take too long. After that, we're gonna saute these mushrooms in the same fat. We wanna maximize all this flavor. Now these mushrooms don't take too long, about 40 seconds to a minute, that's it. And then remove them from the heat, keep them warm in the little bowl on the side. Then we're gonna take our baby gailan that's been resting and drying. We're just gonna heat these guys through. And just like the mushrooms, just put them aside until we're ready to use them. Now I'm gonna deglaze this pan with some white wine because I want the fond from the mushroom. Then I'm gonna add the shallots, and then I'm gonna add a little bit more wine, because what we're gonna do is we're gonna flavor this wine with the shallots, the fond, a little bit of thyme. We're gonna strain this and we're gonna use this to deglaze the pan when we cook the scallops. Now that all the prep work is done, we're gonna go and cook these bad boys. Salt and pepper, and into a ripping hot pan with some olive oil. Now once these guys are in the pan, all you have to do is just let them sit there for a few minutes to start developing a nice crust, which is going to result in some of the best scallops you've ever made. Now the point of basting is to cook the scallops gently on the other side. And just continue to baste these guys. The total cook time for these scallops is about 4 minutes on that side. Then once 4 minutes is up and it feels about medium rare, I like to flip them all over. And once they're done flipped, I turn off the heat, grab a sheet pan or a plate and just take them off. They're done. And after draining off all this extra butter and oil, we're gonna take that fortified wine that we made earlier, and we're gonna deglaze this pan. This beautiful fond left over by the scallops is the start of our gorgeous pan sauce. We're gonna let the wine reduce a little bit, give it a little splash of soy sauce, a little touch of heavy whipping cream, just give this a nice stir and a nice shake, and we're gonna strain it, and we're gonna be left with a beautiful, rich, velvety sauce. All right, we're gonna take a generous scoop of our potato puree, and I like to use an offset spatula and give it a nice little smear, and then just stack our plates. We have the baby gailan, we have the scallops, we're gonna have our king oyster mushrooms and our little shimenjis. Place it all around, make this plate super sexy, and then we're gonna spoon this gorgeous sauce all over our plate. Now, remember, we created a nice crispy crust on our scallops. Let's not drench the tops of our beautiful scallops with sauce and sog them out. Now, because this sauce is so rich, we don't need too much of it. Now, for me, I think saucing plates is one of my favorite aspects of cooking. You just get to add your nice little personal touch to it, make it look just beautiful. Have our crumbled up guanciale for that nice salty aspect, finishing with some Maldon salt. We are done. And look at our beautiful scallops, perfectly seared, nice golden brown crust on it, on a bed of super smooth potato puree with our exotic baby gailan, our sauteed mushrooms, we have king oyster and the baby shimenjis, and that super salty, nice crunchy guanciale with our white wine cream sauce with a touch of soy sauce in it. Oh, I can't wait to dig in. Let's try to build the perfect bite with a little bit of everything on this plate. Guys, I had so much fun making this incredibly delicious scallop dish today. I want to say thank you so much to the folks at Heston, Blue Runner Seafood. Guys, if you like the content, smash the like button down below. Be safe out there. And as always, peace.